Hello, it's Saturday, July the 11th. As we get closer to concluding the book of Colossians, we're in chapter 4, verses 14 and 15 today, and we're going to look at three more characters and how they might apply to us. Three more companions of Paul, fellow servants of Paul. Luke, the beloved physician, and Demas greet you, Paul is writing to the church of Colossae. Greet the brethren who are in Laodicea and Nymphas and the church that is in his house. These are exhortations to the church to do something and greetings from other people to that church to encourage them. Luke, of course, is the writer of one of the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. He was the physician who traveled with Paul throughout all of his missionary journeys to a great extent and was with Paul in some of the great moments of Paul's ministry and was faithful right up until Paul's death. He said, Luke greets you. And Demas greets you. At this point, Demas is still a trusted servant of Paul, but we found out later on when they get to Thessalonica, Demas gets drawn away by something, and he turns against Paul, whether it's pride or money, but something makes him drift away, and he becomes a casualty of the gospel, even though he was once a faithful servant. It's one of those sad reminders, and I've been in the ministry long enough to see many young men, young women who are true to God for a while, but something happens that draws them away. And Demas is one of those. Greet the brethren who are in Laodicea and Nymphas. And that name, Nymphas, in different manuscripts is either feminine or masculine, and then it changes to his house or her house. But it brings up the point that most of the early churches met in homes. You know, there's a movement today among Christians to return to house churches. And it wouldn't be a bad idea as long as those house churches don't just become private little Bible studies that never reach out and try to win people to Christ and try to minister to the world. But the early church met primarily in homes. So they saw themselves as family. They met there and they would have dinner there. They would fellowship there. They might even return and there when they're on their travels. They might spend the night there, but that indicates there were some homes that were of a wealthy nature. There were some people of some means in the early church. But I think it's a beautiful thing to think of. The church didn't grow out of edifices of man's glory and massive buildings. They grew in homes because they were in the heart of the believer. As we think about what Paul had to say to the church of Colossae and the kind of men that traveled with him, may we be like Luke and Nymphas, and not be like Demas, who gets drawn away by something the world has to offer that for that short period of time he deemed more valuable than his faithfulness to Christ. May we be true to the Lord right up to the day he takes us home. Let's pray. Father, thank you for your love and your grace and your mercy. And we thank you that even for people like Demas who fall away and drift away, there's hope for restoration and reconciliation. There still is the reward of having lived for you. Father, we pray that we'll be like Luke and Aristarchus and Tychius and Onesimus and Nymphas, that we will be stalwarts of the faith and live for you until that day you call us home. We thank you for your love, your grace, and your mercy, and may we return that love and devotion by being true to you. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. God bless you. Hope to see you tomorrow in church.